Hello there, it's Kiryu here. Proudly present you another DIY smart sensor named XKC Y25 that is working with Home Assistant. Today I'll show you how to easily create an intelligent non-contact level sensor that can detect whether a liquid is present in a plastic, glass or ceramic container up to 20 mm thick. The idea is the following. The sensor has to be glued to a tank wall or a pipe, and when there is liquid inside that tank at the level of the sensor or above it, the sensor will have stayed on. And when the liquid inside the tank drops below the sensor level, the state of the sensor will become off. That is called a binary sensor in Home Assistant terms, as you see later. And because there is no contact with the liquid, the sensor is suitable for hazardous applications such as detecting toxic substances and all kinds of liquids in containers under high pressure. I got my sensor from AliExpress website where there are three different modifications. Mine is the PNP model. This version costs me around $5 with the shipping. It is waterproof with an IP67 rating. It can work in a humidity range from 5% to 100%. And has an operating temperature range from 0 to 100 Celsius, which makes it quite versatile. By removing the cover, you can adjust the sensor sensitivity. Counterclockwise rotation of the knob will increase the sensitivity, and respectively, clockwise rotation will decrease it. One great use case of this sensor is measuring the level of clean, gray, and brown water in campers or caravans. And my idea is to use this smart non-contact liquid level sensor for exactly that purpose. Apart from the XKC Y25 sensor, next thing that is needed for today's DIY project is an ESP board. I will use a D1 Mini for that purpose, and I'll connect the liquid sensor to that D1 Mini, and then I will upload the ESPHome firmware on it. So I can read the sensor data wirelessly. Do not worry, I will show you the wiring and firmware uploading procedure in just a moment. And it is piece of cake. Third thing that is required is a working Home Assistant. If you don't have such yet, go and register for my Home Assistant webinar, where I'll talk about the all four official methods of Home Assistant installation, plus one stupid easy and secret way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. And final things that are needed are a micro USB cable and optionally an USB power adapter that will be used to power up the D1 Mini as well as the contactless liquid sensor. I bought all the things above from the AliExpress website. The parts are also available in Amazon, but they are slightly more expensive there. Both AliExpress and Amazon links for all of the needed parts for this project can be found in the video description. Now, it is time to wire the future smart contactless liquid detector to the D1 Mini board and then to upload the ESPHome. Here is how I did it. I cut the plastic connector at the end of the sensor cable and I connected the wires directly to the D1 Mini board as follows. Brown wire to the 3V pin, yellow wire to D0 and blue wire to ground pin. Black wire is not connected anywhere. I solder everything and this is the final result. As you can see, this is how I managed to wire my liquid contactless sensor. I'm planning to use this contactless liquid detector in my camper so that I will know when the water tank is running out of water. But I'm wondering, what is your use case for this DIY project? Can you share what's your idea in the comments below? ESPHome dashboard installed as Home Assistant add-on is probably the easiest way to manage ESPHome devices. This method plus several other are well described in this video of mine. If there is such need, go watch it and then come back right here. And this is how I uploaded the ESPHome firmware on the D1 Mini. While I'm inside Home Assistant, I'll press the C button to invoke the search command bar and I'll start typing ESPHome. And I'll select Navigate ESPHome. This will open my ESPHome dashboard. Inside this ESPHome dashboard, I'll click on the New Device button. I'll click on continue. I'll name my new device, for example, liquid sensor. I'll type my Wi-Fi name and password. Then I'll click next. I'll pick a specific board here because I know what my board is. It is the one mini, this one. And I'll click next. I'll leave the auto-generated encryption key and I'll click on skip button. Then I'll click on edit button next to the liquid sensor. And I'll go to the very bottom of the file and I'll paste the following lines. Don't try to remember them, just get them from the video description. The first section will enable the web server of the ESPHome device. And the second section is the configuration of my contactless liquid sensor. The platform is a GPIO and the pin number is GPIO 16, which according to the D1 mini pinout is exactly D0, where I connected my liquid sensor. And I also added this input true and pull down true, as well as device class moisture, because that way this sensor will be represented better in Home Assistant. And finally, I name my sensor liquid sensor. I'll click on save, then install. And now I'll connect my sensor to the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome dashboard are installed. Like that. Then I'll select this third option. I'll pick the server port and the installation of the ESPHome begins. Before I continue to the actual adding of the DIY smart liquid sensor in Home Assistant, I want to give you my free smart home glossary that will help you find the meaning of the 60 plus of the most popular smart home words and abbreviations. Download that smart home glossary right now, free of charge from my website, automatelike.pro/glossary. With glossary or not, here is how I added the sensor in Home Assistant. And uploading of the ESPHome firmware is now complete. The device is now trying to connect to my Wi-Fi. I think it is connected now. Yes, it is. This is my device IP address. Here I can stop this. I can close this. And this sensor should become online, as you can see from this label right here. And now I can click on visit button. This will open the web interface of this device. And now if I try the sensor on these glasses right here, you can see that the sensor is changing its state from on to off depending of its position. But the more interesting part here is adding the device in Home Assistant. I'll press the C button again, I'll type integrations, I'll select navigate integrations, and there is a big chance this device to be auto-detected here. Here it is, liquid sensor. I just have to click on configure button, and the device is now added in my Home Assistant. I can click finish, and here it is, one device with two entities. Currently the liquid sensor is dry. If I try again, the sensor is working pretty good on glass. Let's see on plastic. Yes, it is working as well. And this is ceramic. It is not working pretty good on this ceramic glass for some reason. Later I tried the same test but with another ceramic glass and it works fine. When the sensor is at the level of the water or below it, it turns on and it goes off if it's above the water. Never mind, the plastic and the glass is working great, as you can see. One of the biggest flags of Home Assistant are the automations. You can easily create an automation that will notify you when the liquid in the tank that you are monitoring is below certain level. Here is one quick example. Now I can create automations from here very easily by clicking on this plus button, and these two can be my triggers. Liquid sensor became moist or became dry. I can click on this one, for example, and my trigger will be automatically added. I just have to add an action which can be anything, for example, notify me via phone call or notification or whatever. And finally, I have to click on save. Here is a quick example. Persistent notification create. This will be the name of my demo automation. Save. And now I'll go back to my device info dashboard of the liquid sensor. And now if the sensor becomes wet and then dry, I should receive a notification right here. Liquid sensor is dry. Everything is working as expected. Great. I'm pretty happy with the end result of this DIY smart contactless liquid sensor. And if you managed to create one for yourself, share that in the comments by typing hashtag liquid sensor owned. And I promise to congratulate you personally for the effort. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill. See you next week. Bye.